Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us for the 15th annual Lights of Love lighting celebration for St. Mary's Hospital in Madison. My name is Terry Donlin. I'm a volunteer and a co-chair for this year's Lights of Love celebration. I want to thank you all, along with all the volunteers and the foundation staff, for making this event possible. We've had a crazy last 2 years, and this year again, we're doing the same as 2020. We're doing a virtual program. We would love to have you all here and celebrating with us together. But due to COVID-19, we want to keep everyone safe, remembering that this is in remembrance of those past, those we share life with, and our healthcare workers and military. I want to thank you for joining us and enjoy the celebration.
My name is Susan Leet, and I'm the Supervisor of Pastoral Care at St. Mary's Hospital. I offer this blessing for everyone this evening. God of light and life, in the darkness of winter and in the midst of this very difficult year, you bring cheer to our hearts with the lighting of these trees. May your light shine within our hearts throughout these days and fill us, we pray, with the hope of peace on earth and goodwill to all. Let your blessing rest upon each loved one and honoree represented by these lights. May the joining of their inner glow bring comfort to all those who are separated this holiday season from those they love, whether that distance be due to a new life in heaven, distance on this earth, or our travel restrictions because of the pandemic. May the white lights of those who are no longer with us remind us to see clearly the legacy of their lives and the brightness of a future that only we can help create in honor of their memories. May the red lights of those living honorees whom we appreciate this evening warm our hearts with the shared values of compassion, respect, excellence, stewardship, and community. Our blue lights also shine and remind us of those who served our country. The word blue might be described as symbolizing trust, loyalty, wisdom, confidence, intelligence, and faith. Surely these words speak truthfully of those who serve others. And we also pray that your spirit might strengthen all those in our midst who dedicate their lives to providing exceptional healthcare service that reveals the healing presence of God. Sustain our healthcare workers and their families through every difficult day. Grant that these blue healing lights may be a reminder of their daily work, the sacrifice of their families and loved ones, and their passion for excellence. And our final prayer. Make us all, I pray, instruments of your more perfect peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. Amen.
Hello, my name is Joanne Johnson, Director of Volunteer Services and Guest Relations here at St. Mary's. When I was asked to speak today on how much the Lights of Love program means to St. Mary's and how much St. Mary's means to me, I was very thankful for this opportunity to share a story and a letter that I wrote recently. Dear 4 East and 5 West staff, cardiac physicians, surgeons, hospitalists, and all the hospital support care teams that cared for me when I was hospitalized this past August for a medical emergency. Strands of lights have been purchased through the Lights of Love program in your honor. This program offers a meaningful way to express my gratitude to you for the exceptional care that you provided to me and that saved my life. As I reflect on the experience while under your care, tears of emotions continue to flow for the immense appreciation that I will always have for each of you. After weeks of ER visits ambulance rides, and doctor visits, I passed out while I was walking on the sidewalk. An anonymous nurse stopped and offered help. She told my daughter, Kate, who is also a nurse, that she works at St. Mary's Hospital, and she would never leave us until the Sun Prairie paramedics arrived. She comforted Kate and assured her that help was on the way and I was going to be okay. I only wish that I knew this nurse's name so I could thank her for her kindness. Another passerby stopped and offered help. He was a physician at the UW Hospital emergency room. Upon reviewing my EKG, the PA offered to ride in the ambulance with us and the paramedics to St. Mary's Hospital. The paramedics and the PA told me we finally captured what the doctors needed to diagnose your symptoms. For this, I was extremely grateful. I was admitted to 4 East, which is the cardiac unit. The unknown of what would happen made me anxious until I met my amazing primary nurse, Emily B. She helped Kate and I feel comfortable immediately. Her calming presence was a gift, and she reassured us that I couldn't be in any better place or be in any better hands than with the most experienced team that would take care of me. This confidence remained with us throughout our experience. Within a short period of time, my condition declined rapidly, and I was in a grave situation. My heart rate dropped quickly and often, and from that moment on, Emily never left my side. She and Kate quickly became my coach, my confidant, and my rock. They gave me hope during these dark moments. The cardiac team was called in for an emergency procedure to insert a temporary pacemaker. The 4 East staff were phenomenal, as they, without hesitation, supported Emily by offering to take care of her assigned patients. The room quickly filled up with staff to prep me for surgery. I want to personally thank everyone in my room. I wish I knew each of you, each of your names, so I could personally recognize you. You know who you are. The 4 East staff was an amazing, cohesive team, and each and every one of them worked to the top of their potential to save my life. Everyone paused in silence as my daughter prayed over all of us for strength and hope. Until the cardiac surgical team arrived, Emily held my hand with her gentle, calming, reassurance voice and watched the heart monitor and coached me through continuous breathing exercises. I believe this was to keep me conscious. Emily held one of my hands tight, and Kate held tight to the other. When the cardiologist arrived, he welcomed Emily and Kate to walk alongside my bed until we reached the cardiac lab. Upon arrival, my confidence was a little shaken, and the cardiac team quickly made me feel comfortable. Their fun sense of humor put me to ease and helped me focus on their conversation and not on the procedure. I knew I was in good hands. They didn't seem worried, so why would I be worried? I thought to myself. Following my procedure, I was admitted to 5 West Intensive Care Unit, where the continuum of care continued to be exceptional. I was blessed with an amazing team of nurses that kept me safe and helped me heal for several days. Special thanks to Haley, Brandy, Courtney, and the CNAs Megan and Elena for their outstanding care. They not only cared for me, but they also cared for Kate to make her stay more comfortable. I was also grateful to Father Pat, who offered a blessing in prayers throughout my stay. You see, I received a permanent pacemaker a few days later, and the continuum of exceptional care continued with excellent care by the cardiac surgeon, the OR staff, and the PACU, which is the post-anesthesia care unit. I was then transferred back to 4 East to recover from my procedure and to prepare for discharge. Through this medical emergency, every care team member exemplified our mission. Through our exceptional healthcare services, we reveal the healing presence of God. Each of you, my caregivers, gave me the gift of life. And in turn, I am giving you the gift of holiday lights that will shine brightly in your honor. You will always have a special place in my heart as a bright spot in my life forever. I'm grateful to be here today to share this story and express my heartfelt appreciation to all the caregiver teams here at St. Mary's. Thanks to you, I have a bright and healthy future and look forward to growing old with my husband, my family, and especially my 5 grandchildren. With heartfelt gratitude from a grateful patient, Joanne. I also want to take a moment to thank St. Mary's Hospital volunteers and SSM Health Foundation for their dedication and work to keep the Lights of Love program available for everyone to remember those who have made a difference in our lives. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Kyle Nondorf. I'm the president of SSM Health St. Mary's Hospital, Madison. Incredibly grateful to be part of this program tonight. This is my second time to be part of the Lights of Love Christmas tree lighting program. And it's an incredible way to recognize those who have made a significant impact on our lives. Each light represents someone very meaningful. And for me, my sister, Andrea Nondorf, passed during my time at St. Mary's Hospital. Knowing that she is represented with the Lights of Love is very personal and meaningful to me. It is also meaningful to me to know that lights represent our incredible healthcare professionals who during the pandemic have been steadfast in their support of our mission. Again, would like to thank you for the support of the Lights of Love program that help recognize patients, families, and our healthcare professionals. Your support goes to the areas of greatest need that continue to further our mission. Thank you and enjoy the lights.
Hi, I'm Dina Boyle, Executive Director, St. Mary's Foundation. We are so proud to collaborate with St. Mary's volunteers on the Lights of Love program, a cherished tradition and a truly meaningful way to remember those who have made a difference in our lives. I'd like to take a moment to recognize the individual and corporate donors who have generously sponsored trees for this year's program. Bylaw Office, Dr. Frank and Cindy Byrne, Epstein Ewan Architects, the family of Scott and Sharon Frank, Gordon Flesh Company, iMedCorp, J.H. Findorf & Son, Madison Radiologists, Lucid Health, Marquette Associates, Oak Park Place, Sargenian's Floor Covering, Robert and Angela Tramberg, and Vita Plus Corporation.
On behalf of St. Mary's Madison volunteers, I would also like to thank the 23 donors who purchased a strand of lights and all who purchased individual lights this year.
We would also like to add a special thanks to Bruce Company for their help with our trees. Thank you.
Greeting cards have all been sent. Christmas rushes through, but I still have one wish to make, a special one for you. Merry Christmas, darling. We're apart, that's true, but I can dream, and in my dreams I'm Christmasing with you. Holidays are joyful, there's always something new, but every day's a holiday when I'm near to you. The lights on my tree, I wish you could see, I wish it every day.
Thank you.
for you and I, baby, I miss you most at Christmas time, and I can't get you, no, 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 get you off my mind. Every other season comes along and I'm alright, but then I miss you most at Christmas time. Oh, in the springtime, those memories start to fade with the April rain. Through the summer days, till autumn's leaves are gone, snow begins to fall, and then I miss you most at Christmas time, and I can't get you, no, 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 get you off my mind. Every other season comes along and I'm all right, but then I'm
time.